Today we will see which semiconductor is electrically neutral. Will it be intrinsic, or n-type, or p-type? Which out of this one is electrically neutral? Generally, we think that intrinsic semiconductor is electrically neutral, n-type semiconductor is electrically negative, p-type semiconductor is electrically positive. But that is wrong. All the three semiconductors, that is intrinsic, n-type, and p-type, that means semiconductor may be intrinsic or extrinsic, that is electrically neutral. So simply we can say semiconductor is electrically neutral irrespective of it, whether it is intrinsic or extrinsic. Now we will see how. Okay. So before going for that one, first we will see a general atom. If you are going for an atom, whether it is electrically neutral or not, we know that one, every atom is electrically neutral, because every atom will be consisting of equal amount of positive charge and equal amount of negative charge. So look at this one. This is a structure of an atom. Okay. So that will be consisting of nucleus and protons along with electrons. Neutron is going to be neutral charge. Protons and electrons are going to be charges. Electron is consisting of negative charge, proton is a positive charge, and electron charge is, charge of electron is -1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulombs, whereas proton charge is +1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulombs. Only magnitude is going to be changed, but the charge is same. So since every atom consisting of equal amount of electrons and equal amount of protons, the atom is electrically neutral. So very important statement is every atom is electrically neutral. Since every atom is electrically neutral, you can show some examples also. So silicon, germanium, which are going to be examples of semiconductor, and phosphorus, arsenic, okay, antimony. So these are examples of pentavalent impurities, and some other examples of aluminium, okay, boron, gallium, indium. These are examples of trivalent impurities. Okay, examples of trivalent impurities, examples of pentavalent impurities, and these are semiconductors simply. So whatever it is, they are going to be treated as atoms. So every atom is electrically neutral. Now consider intrinsic semiconductor case. In intrinsic semiconductor is also called as pure semiconductor. Okay, so pure means it will consisting of atoms of all identical nature. So for example, pure semiconductor means, for example, if you are taking silicon crystal is intrinsic semiconductor, germanium crystal is also intrinsic semiconductor, carbon crystal. So a crystal means it will be crystal is having a unique structure which is repeating regularly. And silicon crystal will only consisting of silicon atoms, and every silicon atom is electrically neutral. May it be consisting of any number of silicon atoms. Okay, so the total charge is going to be neutral. So intrinsic semiconductor is electrically neutral. Remember that one. Okay, intrinsic semiconductor, that means a semiconductor which consisting of all identical atoms. That may be, for example, silicon crystal, germanium crystal, or carbon crystal, like this. So every atom is electrically neutral. Hence, even though if you are adding, okay, infinite number of atoms, but each is having a neutral charge, so the total is going to be neutral. So intrinsic semiconductor is electrically neutral. Now come for n-type semiconductor. N-type semiconductor is added when intrinsic n-type semiconductor is formed when pentavalent impurities added to intrinsic semiconductor. So pentavalent impurity, if you add it to intrinsic semiconductor, what it results is n-type semiconductor. Pentavalent impurities are nothing but examples: phosphorus, arsenic, antimony. Okay, these are the best examples of pentavalent impurities, which has 5 valence electrons in its outermost orbits. But they are also neutral. Every atom is neutral, so that whether it is phosphorus or arsenic or antimony, whatever you are adding pentavalent, that is also neutral. Intrinsic semiconductor is also neutral, pentavalent atom is also neutral. So neutral plus neutral, what you are going to get is neutral itself. Next, p-type semiconductor is also in the same way. P-type semiconductor is formed when trivalent impurity is added to intrinsic semiconductor, that is pure semiconductor. It is already neutral. Okay, trivalent impurity, that is nothing but trivalent atoms. It may be aluminium, boron, gallium, indium. They are all neutral in nature. Okay, so the trivalent impurity is also neutral, pure semiconductor is also neutral. So finally, neutral plus neutral is neutral. So we can say every semiconductor, whether it is intrinsic or extrinsic, is electrically neutral. Okay, you may be thinking that it will be having n-type semiconductor is having electrons as majority charge carriers than holes. Okay, then you can think electrons are more, so that it is going to be negatively charged, but it is not like this. Okay, so remember it, every semiconductor is electrically neutral. Because even though n-type semiconductor, if you are consisting of majority carriers are going to be electrons, electrons are going to be getting holes plus, holes plus positive ions. So the total charge is going to be electrons, number of electrons is equal to number of holes present in that one plus positive ions created because of pentavalent atoms. This will be having equal number, so that when you are going with completely, so total negative charge is equal to total positive charge, that makes n-type semiconductor as electrically neutral. Similarly for p-type also, holes are majority carriers, holes are more, but the sum total number of holes is equal to electrons present in p-type plus negative ions. Okay, every trivalent atom, when it gains an electron, it becomes negative ion. Okay, by that time there is a vacancy created, that is called as hole. So because of this nature, p-type is electrically neutral, and because of this one, n-type is electrically neutral. So finally the conclusion is every semiconductor is electrically neutral.